Trees aren't doing so well in Indiana. This is the third consecutive year we've had water deficit issues, coupled with the fact that we've had no snowfall, which has kind of started our trees off in a negative water deficit to begin with. And they're starting to express symptoms of drought in a very serious way. The first symptoms that you see would be wilting or curling of the leaves, and then some trees will advance into scorching. You'll see marginal browning, and actually early fall collar and leaf drop is not uncommon. We're right in the middle of probably the worst as far as symptoms go. If you look on the ground around your yard or in your parks, you'll actually see leaves on the ground, which is not typical for July. And then also you'll see early fall collar up in the trees. They don't turn yellow this early in the growing season. And now we're starting to see lots of yellowing and lots of brown, even some reds showing up because of the lack of water. The long-term impact of drought is what I'm most concerned with. And the fact that a lot of times we won't see the results of what the drought really did until maybe a year or 2 years later. Watering bans can be very detrimental to helping keep your tree alive. However, different communities have different rules with their watering bans. For example, you may not be able to water your turf or grass, but you can keep your gardens and trees alive. So there is a difference. You want to check with your local authorities to make sure what your watering ban includes and doesn't include. Trees are kind of like people in the fact that they can suffer from heat stroke or heat stress. As temperatures increase, their water loss increases. The general rule is for every 20 degrees that the temperature goes up above 40 degrees, water loss and respiration doubles. So in these 90 and 100 degrees temperatures, they're losing water faster than we can replace it. Some of the things that homeowners can do to protect their trees during drought situations, of course, water. For younger and newly established trees, the rule of 5 plus 5 works very well. That's adding 5 gallons of water plus 5 gallons for every inch of diameter on the trunk. On mature trees, make sure you get at least 1 inch of water on the root zone during times when you don't have adequate rainfall. Another important step you can take to prevent drought symptoms is mulch. Mulch isn't just to be pretty in the landscape, it serves a very important functional aspect as well. It preserves the moisture and prevents evaporation. It also reduces competition with other plants around it. I think Hoosiers should be very concerned about their trees and the situation we have right now. I think we're going to see a long-term impact which could be devastating to our urban forests. And we may not notice those impacts again for 2 or 3 years. But be aware that drought impact is not just current year, it's subsequent years as well. You can find more information about taking care of your trees in drought at the Purdue Extension website. That's www.purdue.edu/drought.